Here we are at the Georgetown restaurant on Mount Washington. Pittsburgh is right over there. We've been down there looking around. It's actually quite beautiful. We rode the Duquesne Incline up here, built in the 1870s. It's pretty cool. It certainly looks like it was built in the 1870s because the paint looks like it hasn't been painted since the 1870s either, but it's pretty cool. We're waiting for the lights to come on over the city. Kurt's going to show you what it looks like right now. The sun's just gone down. There might be a little bit of reflections in the buildings, and then there'll be a night view.
This city was formed at the confluence of the Allegheny and the Monongahela River, and below their confluence, it becomes the Ohio River. So this is, we're right at the beginning of the very headwater of the Ohio River. It goes on down past Cincinnati, down into Kentucky, and eventually into the Mississippi, and on down to New Orleans.
I knew a couple of them. They were my rollerblading friends when I was in the rollerblading. I said to smile too.
Oh, the smile, yeah. Oh, yeah, I don't think it's lost anything.
It needs the fountain going.
It's nice to see people put money back in.
The fountain's off for another year. Okay, did you make the shot?
It's a time lapse.
What's his name? Don't move it.
You have a lot of tape.
The fullback for the Steelers, they call him the Buck. He lives not too far from where we live.
It's going to get dark. I guess I should have started
every
that.
Every year, a lot of kids would go to his house and turn the street because he would come out in the yard.
Is it?
Take pictures with
is it a white shot?
It's so great.
He's the nicest guy in the whole
world. The only problem is in the lower right.
I'm walking on the original National Road. Braddock was buried somewhere around here, and later he was moved up on the hill, which is marked by a monument. But this is the actual National Road. Wow. This is where they buried him. They buried him in the road because they were afraid the Indians would dig him up and desecrate the body.
So this was actually called Braddock's Road originally, or Braddock's Trail.
As well, it should be called Braddock's Trail because he was actually, you trailed on top of him when you were on the road.
His entrails were part of the trail.
This was the National Road, the original National Road, and as you can hear, Route 40 is just a few hundred feet from here. Here is the spot to which Braddock was actually moved, and his remains are actually currently interred. We don't think he's going to move again.
I'm with Major Washington's contingent of British colonial troops, and we're just above the French peace delegation of Count Jumonville. They're camping down in this glen. This is the exact spot where Washington's men fired the shots that started the French and Indian War, which became the Seven Years' War in Europe. We're looking right down into the rocky area where the French contingent was camped on the morning of May 28, 1754. Washington and his troops and his Indian guides were lined up along this little escarpment here and opened fire. According to Washington and the British account, the French saw them as they were getting up and fired first, and the British, Washington's contingent, returned fire in self-defense. The French say that the British troops lined up here and opened fire first without announcing themselves. Something that's still debated, who fired first, we'll never know, but clearly two groups of men not trusting each other, all armed with muskets and with their own Indians. So whoever saw the other guys probably fired first. Where Barbara is standing is where Washington and his contingent of British colonial troops lined the escarpment up there and fired down on the French peace contingency. This is Jumonville Glen. From the bottom, looking up, the Frenchmen were camped in and among these rocks to protect themselves from the rain that had been falling steadily all night. I'm sure they were cold and miserable.
managed to keep their powder dry, however. There's Barbara. She's standing right where Lieutenant Colonel Washington, the young Washington, stood, getting ready to make his first mistake of his brilliant career.
Washington's first battlefield, prelude to the French and Indian War. Lieutenant Colonel George Washington, in command of a company of Virginia militia, 40 in number, assisted by the half-king, Tenacha Harrison, and a company of Indians, surprised, killed, wounded, or captured the entire engaged French force under command of Ensign Jumonville. Hidden below this ledge of rock, since known as Washington's Rocks, they did this on May 28, 1754. This obscure skirmish began the war that set the world on fire. From Jumonville to a world war. The 15-minute skirmish fought here on May 28, 1754 had long-term consequences. 1 month later, 600 French soldiers and 100 Indians under Captain Deville, Jumonville's brother, left Fort Duquesne to avenge ourselves. On July 3rd, the French and Indian forces surrounded almost 400 British troops at nearby Fort Necessity and forced to surrender. In 1755, the French and Indians defeated Major General Edward Braddock's larger British army at the Battle of Monongahela. Tensions between the two powers increased, and in 1756, they officially declared war on each other. The French and Indian War, also called the Seven Years' War in Europe, was fought on four continents and three oceans before it ended in 1763. Was it Braddock's grave we just saw? Where was he from?
England.
So he never went back to England.
And we have found the site of Fort Necessity, built by George Washington and his British Army pals back in 1754, as they were on their way to deliver an ultimatum to the French to clear out of the Ohio Valley country because the British were coming and they didn't want the French people to be here anymore. The French had their own idea. They were coming eastward to tell the British to stay out of French territory. And so Washington and his group of men surprised one morning the French peace delegation. A firefight ensued, about a 15-minute-long skirmish, and Washington's Indian ally, the half-king, tomahawked the wounded Count de Jumonville to death. And so basically Washington's first military outing was a huge failure. It was an international political incident, and it precipitated the not only the French and Indian War for control of North America, but it started the Seven Years' War between England and France, and it was settled in 1763 by the Treaty of Paris. So let's go inside and see what the inside of the fort looks like now. This is a recreated fort, by the way. This is not the original fort, but this is the site. Not really much to it now, and of course there wasn't much to it then either. It was basically just a stockade where they took logs that they had cut and sharpened the ends of them so nobody could climb over, gave them pretty good protection against the balls from that the French and the Indians were firing from the wood line. And there was originally the original fort. There was a little hut here. Maybe you can see the doorway here and some of the foundation logs.
There was at this place a small staccato fort made in a circular form around a small house that stood in the middle of it to keep our provisions and ammunition. The simple log cabin provided protection from the elements and pilfering of British supplies. Flour, corn, salt, gunpowder, musket balls, cannon shot, and rum were the principal items in the storage. Using one of the cabin logs as a podium, British officers made a copy of the surrender document.
Washington didn't realize, because his French wasn't very good and the document was a little smeared, he didn't realize that when he signed the surrender agreement that allowed he and his men to leave, he was also admitting and taking personal responsibility for killing de Jumonville.
Here we are. This is a trench now filled with snow, but I think this battle happened in May and it was raining. So the British soldiers were laying in shallow puddles of water in this trench. Must have been very, very scary. These are the woods from which the French and Indians were firing. They were very protected with all these trees, the hills, the ridges, whereas The fort is just here in the middle of a whole meadow.